are from FKPM5A. We'd like to present about an interview. Okay, firstly, let me introduce our team members. My name is Aini Shafrina. This is Siti Narain. This is Hazwani. This is Hatta Asfa. And lastly, this is Asfa Hazi. Okay, we have been assigned an interview and we have chosen Majlis Sukanik Kedah. We have been assisted with Mr. Amir, Assistant Director, and Mr. Azmi. The purpose of this interview to know the nature organization of this layout, decision making, communication style, and any activities that occurs in the office. First, we start the interview by asking Mr. Amir his background. Okay, his full name is Mr. Amir. His full name is Mr. Amir Izzat bin Ismail. His status is married. Okay, his school, he work at Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah. He work for 1 year. Okay, his qualification is graduate from a bachelor degree in sport management at UiTM Shah Alam. Okay, his position at Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah is assistant director. Okay, the challenge that he faced in Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah is Mr. Amir said that he needs to upgrade thing the administrator department. It is not perfect, but it should be a good addition in terms of administration, because previously nobody hold the position of assistant director at Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah. The workers always go directly director if anything happened. Now he starts slightly from bottom to top. Mr. Amir also do instruction from the government such as sub-circular, directive, treasury, and Mr. Amir make a good addition to the right to follow and apply the latest in Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah. Okay, next the question is what Mr. Amir duties in Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah? He will be monitor the administrator process from time to time. Under the administration, have many kind of sessions such as financial, sport asset, and asset in the office. He must be monitor this meeting should be held. Okay, and then we'll make sure that each unit should play their perspective role. Example such as the asset must report how is today, it is appropriate condition or not. Okay, next is he must decide all problem that company face. Okay, next is I will pass to Asfazi.
Okay, thank you Aina Shukarina. Okay, next we will proceed to the objective of the organization. We ask the chairman about the objective of organization. Then he told us that the organization objective is to promote the sport in the country with attempt and improve the performance of athletes from the grassroots to participate in competition at state, national and international. Okay, the second question is about the organization structure. They say they use a lateral or horizontal structure. For the third question, how they want to maintain quality of work among workers in his department. Encik Ahmed told us that problem, they will solve the problem by face-to-face by calling all the workers and trying to find a solution. Then, we'll do a meeting with the workers and find the best solution and hear what the problem that they face. Besides that, they will make a personal talk with the worker if they have any problem with their work. And the last question is how many departments they have. There are three main sections for the first one is administration, and the second one is development, and the lastly is financial. Next, I will pass to Siti Norain.
Okay. We ask Mr. Amir how he communicates with his subordinates in a formal and informal way. He then explained to us the informal way he usually talks with his subordinates in meeting or discussion to settle or discuss the matter related to the department. Meanwhile, in a formal way, he will ask his subordinates directly what he needs because he wants to narrow the gap between the top management and his subordinates. He believes that by using informal communication, it is easier to ask people to do their job Between these two types of communications, they communicate more in informal way rather than formal way. His assistant, Mr. Azmi, said, in this department, while working, they have to abide by the rules of the office, respect others, but outside they are more like friends. So, it is easier to ask anything without touching their sensitive issue because they are close enough to know everyone's personality. I asked him about the rising problems while communicating. Mr. Amir explained that there were some problems that happened before, such as when the workers does not listen to his request or miscommunication happens during communicating. His assistant, Mr. Azmi, said, usually the reason why the worker reluctant to do the job or delay the job is because of their personal reasons. According to Mr. Amir, there are a few problem solving ways that they use, which is if he can solve it by himself, so he will try to solve it, but if he cannot solve it or it is out of his power, he will refer the problem to the upper management. But usually they will gather all the head station or related workers to discuss the matter and implication of medications. Next, I will proceed to Hatta Aspar.
Okay, thank you, Siti Nurain. All of the question has been answered well. Mr. Amir said, all the problems raised in Tuan Jesukan Negeri Kedah will be solved in professional ways. Based on our interview session, we identified that Mr. Amir used a chain of command, which organizational principle that identify who report to whom within an organization. Next, depending on how decision is being made, based on our interview, if the problem occur at a lower level, it still can become over, the problem will be resolved quickly. And next, Mr. Ahmed said that the problems will be discussed in the meeting. Same goes to what Siti Nurain explained. Lastly, from our observation, there is some barrier in problem solving, which is from point of systematic and economy. There is no doubt, according to Mr. Amir, the barrier in office sometimes, if the computer breaks down, he will use another ways of innovation to solve the problem. And from the economic side, he said Majlis Sukan Negeri Kedah, financial is related back to our national economy. So that's all from me, and I will pass to Hazwani.
Okay, next our observation is about office environment. The factor that include is lighting, color scheme, acoustic, and condition of the air in workplace. According to Mr. Amir, their office using semi-direct lighting. Semi-direct lighting system is direct approximately 60 to 90% of the illumination downward. The remainder of the illumination direct upward and then will reflect to the downward. Color scheme around our workplace also can give a physical and psychological impact to employees. In their meeting rooms, they using light blue color, while at the around employees' workplace area, they are using light yellow. The colors can create calm and retiring moods. The color also suitable with the effects of lighting that have been applied. Their office security dimension on how they protect the organization property, apart from lock or the door, They have installed closed circuit television CCTV around office workplace, parking area and storeroom. They also hire a security guard to check at around office per hour to make sure that nothing will happen. They also install the fire detector to detect and warn people through video and audio applicants when smoke, fire, carbon monoxide or other emergencies are present. In case the fire happens, they have a fire extinguisher as action to erase the fire while the firemen arrive. Also, to protect the organization vital information, they will keep the important document in the safety box. They also will check and record the document in and out. The information of the borrower will be recorded, such as their name, date of borrowed, and signature. Next, about distribution of noise and air. According to Mr. Azmi, they are not usually having a disturbance of noise and air because their office are not surrounding with factory or other place that produce no noise and air pollution. But they have installed exhaust fan at the storeroom to protect the equipment from damage. In our suggestion, they maybe have to reduce the number of aircon. They have 3 aircon at their meeting groups, where I found that it's not suitable with the immensity of the room. It's because spending a full day in an air-conditioned environment, the air circulation can transmit infectious respiratory diseases that can be harmful for their health, such as headache, fatigue, mucous membranes irritation, breathing difficulties and skin irritations. To have a good physical health is important because it can affect their job performance and productivity. So that's all.
That's all from us. Thank you.